let's do a size comparison between all the pocket pistols that I have. In the middle we have the Beretta Nano, which I've given much fanfare over the few videos that I've done about it. And then we have the Kel Tec, the PF9, which most people are familiar with. And then on the far side here, we have the Kel Tec 380, which most people would also be familiar with. Even if you don't have a 380, most people have seen the LCPs at the gun shows and things like that. So I just wanted to give you an idea of the size difference between these three. I've had a couple questions about it, specifically about the Car PM9, which I don't have, but the Car PM9 would actually probably be smaller than these two guns, and it's especially smaller than the Kel Tec. But most people actually know with the size of these guns, whereas they might not have actually held a Nano, they've held the Kel Tec. The biggest size difference I see between them is in the grip, the actual physical overall size. So we'll move this off. I gotta take the magazine out to drop a slide. Excuse me. So let's see here. Let's do this. And most people do this real famous where they hold the slides together, so I'll just do the same thing. If you'll notice, the Beretta Nano is actually about a quarter of an inch shorter from the extreme back. What I've done is I've lined this nub up here, because that would actually technically be the extreme back. And it is about a quarter of an inch shorter overall. Let's make sure I get them lined up nice, and then we'll get them in focus on the camera. It's kind of hard to see there, but it is shorter. And the grip angle is probably, I don't know, a little bit more vertical on the Kel Tec. The Kel Tec actually does look overall bigger in dimension than the Nano. And it is. Now the Nano is heavier. I don't have a scale. I thought I did. These are safe. So here's that. What other dimensions can we look at here? The height? I guess we could do the height. That's a good idea. See how this... There's a... you know... It doesn't, when you look at the specs and it says that it's a quarter of an inch smaller or an eighth of an inch smaller, it doesn't sound like much, you know? But when you carry like I do, it makes a significant difference. As you've seen in my other videos, I can't carry this Kel Tec like I carry this Nano. You know, so while the Kel Tec is an amazing gun, it actually is thicker there. And you know, if you have the Kel Tec in a holster, or you're carrying it in the waistband, you don't even notice that it's there. But you can't always carry like that in certain situations, so... You know, plus, I struggled to get the Kel Tec to feed a hollow point. So let me do this. And we'll show you the difference with this really mouse gun, which, you know, this is the kind of gun that you could carry in any situation at all. You know, no matter what you have on. I mean, you could have a Speedo, and you could probably tuck away this P380 somewhere, and nobody would really know it's there. Or they would just assume that you were happy to see him. So let's just lay this guy over the top to show you maybe the dimension differences. I'm trying to get it straight here. A little upside down. Line the tops of the slides up. Significant difference. Let me go ahead and do that. There we go. That's beautiful. So now they're flush with each other. Well, I messed it up. Try and do this in one take. There's a significant difference there in the overall height right here. The overall height, which to me, that in order to carry concealed, this overall height and the thickness are the two most important dimensions. Because, you know, most people are like, well, I like the extra grip. You know, I just can't shoot this Kel Tec because the when I hold it, my pinky doesn't end up on the gun. Well, you know, this dimension right here is what usually prints the most and sticks out and gets caught on your shirt. You know, if you go to reach up on a shelf, you know, if you're a little fat boy like me, you know, your shirt doesn't always land perfectly every time. You know, it gets stuck in between your love handles and the handle of this, which technically wouldn't be a love handle, it'd be a war handle. That's a horrible joke. So, this is the most important dimension for concealed carry right here. This width, the weight, and this height. You know, if I can get it to go to the camera right. You know, this overall length, it might be important if it's this long, which is always better in some circumstances. But when you're trying to tuck it in the pants, this length really doesn't matter too much because most people can accommodate for this. But they can't accommodate for this because this is the part that sticks out of your pants. You know, so when you, sometimes you have to sacrifice a little bit of grip length in order to conceal in every, you know, situation. One of the things that I determined when I decided to get a concealed carry permit is to carry 90% of the time. If I can carry, then I should carry. Now, there are circumstances when you can't, like at work or, you know, in certain environments. If you can carry, you should carry. And something like this or something like this, you know, you have to make a sacrifice in ergonomics to fill your obligation to carry. So, okay, I ranted. This Kel Tec is actually 0.77 inches thick. I looked it up. It's less than 0.8. This Kel Tec is 0.88. So if I can do this, let's just put these guys right here. You know, I'm gonna pick this up. Show you the differences in thickness. Definitely smaller Kel Tec, it's thinner. I don't want to ramble too much. If I could get a better angle with this camera, which I could probably pick it up and get a better angle, but it's all right. You know, that just gives you an idea of the size. You know, this thing weighs, I mean, nothing compared to this thing. And this Kel Tec feels significantly heavier than this Kel Tec. But when you pick up a Beretta, the Kel Tec does feel lighter. And this is probably pushing 20 ounces with a loaded magazine. So, that's basically my comparison in size, just so you can get a feel for the three. You guys have a good night.